private tertiary institutions. And definitely we exited monotechnics and research institutes, centers of excellence, under whatever name. And it's very clear, therefore, that we could not breach our law by attempting to go back. But let me say this. As the debate has gone on about the likelihood of making some attempt to expand or include a few additional entities that could benefit, I know that we are always conscious of the dangers of wanting to bring on board too many beneficiaries and therefore diluting the original concept.
ETF running between 1993 and 2010, well, indeed up to 2011, applied intervention funds across the firmament of the education sector. And what that meant is that from the basic up to tertiary. And I must say that in all cases, as it was for only public institutions. Although at that time the number was definitely larger, primary, secondary school, monotechnics, research institutes, some centers of excellence, universities, polytechnic, and college of education. But government, in its wisdom, realized that it amounted to thinly applying the resources from the 2% education tax, and that there was need to streamline and refocus, and refocusing essentially and exclusively on public tertiary institutions only.
Would want to do business to continue as usual, so long as there is a market. Our population is our major strength, and this is a very good source of market for any company around the world. So in our own day, in their own terms, they may not want to impart that technology onto Nigerians. If we reduce the level of technology, foreign technology consumption, that means very little market will allow them to pay their technical partners. If the central bank doesn't see certificate from NOTA, it will not honor any application for foreign currency transfer to the technical partners abroad. So we must have to issue them their certificate.